Hey folks, this is Riker. Battle.net is no more. Long live Battle.net. That's right, this week Blizzard announced that they're actually doing away with the name Battle.net. All the functionality of Battle.net will apparently be retained, but they're just moving away from that name and going to be moving more towards things like Blizzard Voice and Blizzard whatever. Their exact quote is, "We're going to be transitioning away from using the Battle.net name for our gaming service and the functionality connected to it. Battle.net technology will continue to serve as a central nervous system for Blizzard games. Nothing is changing in that regard. We'll just be referring to our various products and services using the Blizzard name instead." And the examples that they pointed to was Blizzard Streaming and Blizzard Voice. And the main reason that they're doing this is, quote, "Over time, we've seen that there's been occasional confusion and inefficiencies related to having two separate identities under which everything falls, Blizzard and Battle.net." Oh, I guess that makes sense. It's way too confusing to the general public to have two different names for related things. Like, it's bad enough that we have to remember that our games, like Warcraft and Starcraft and Diablo and Overwatch, that we have to remember that those games are affiliated with Blizzard. But to also have to remember that we're connecting through Battle.net, it's too much to expect of the general public. All those gamers that play Electronic Arts games on Origin, they're rocket scientists. They're super geniuses who don't get confused by having two different names for things. Or Ubisoft and Uplay, or Valve and Steam. And we all know that Apple, the tech company, would have never become a household name, known by everyone in the world, if they hadn't branded all their products by that same name. The Apple Pad, and the Apple Pod, and the Apple Phone. Okay, in all seriousness, have there been instances where people who are not familiar at all with Blizzard games might be a little confused by what Battle.net is? Maybe. Is it such a significant deterrent as to be a reason to change this name? I don't think so. This is a pure marketing move, and that's fine. It just seems odd to pitch it in a way that it's to eliminate these confusions. I'm not happy about this change. I don't know about you guys. As a longtime Blizzard fan, I'm not happy about the change, but I can't say I'm incensed about it. I'm not, you know, starting a riot, but, you know, on a 5-point scale, I'm slightly displeased. I mean, here's the thing. From a marketing perspective, yes, it makes sense from a branding perspective to brand your stuff Blizzard this, Blizzard that, BlizzardNet, or the Blizzard Portal, Blizzard Launcher. But this decision should have been made 20 years ago, because Battle.net is now 20 years old. In 1996, Battle.net launched with the original Diablo. Battle.net was devised as the first multiplayer connectivity thing for the first Diablo game. So now, on Battle.net's 20th anniversary, it's getting shut down, or it's getting retired as a name. Which is kind of ironic, because I recently made a joke in a video about Diablo's 20th anniversary this year, in which they would announce that they're retiring Diablo. Let's hope that's not what's gonna happen. But yeah, while it would make sense to have done this 20 years ago, even 15, let's say 5 years under the name Battle.net, but 20 years, you're throwing away 20 years of brand recognition. Now the funny thing is, they could have let the name Battle.net fade into the background years ago. I think Warcraft 3 was the last game to really use Battle.net in an evident way. After that, it just sort of faded away. It served as the backbone for Blizzard's multiplayer, but it wasn't evident. When you're playing World of Warcraft, you didn't know you were connecting to Battle.net servers. It was when they launched the Battle.net client a few years ago to serve as a hub for all their games that the name Battle.net really came back into the public's eye. So it just seems bizarre to go against the decision they made a few years ago. I mean, that would have been the time to rename it. Now Battle.net is more obvious than ever because they've pushed us to use the Battle.net app to launch all our games through that. I was opposed to that at first. I just wanted to launch StarCraft too, right? I didn't want to have to load up the Battle.net app and then launch the game, but over time I became accustomed to it and I use it much like many people use Steam, for instance, as a social hub and to load their games. So I get that some people like super don't care. I mean, I care a little bit, and I think most people who are Blizzard fans and have been for a long time will care at least a little bit, but if you like super don't care at all, it's probably because you're maybe newer to Blizzard or not too familiar with it. But like, what if, and I think this can apply to most gamers. Most gamers use Steam, right? What if one day Valve decided to rename Steam the Valve Store or the Valve Portal? You would be a little bothered by that, wouldn't you? Because now you're not going to tell your friends, oh, add me on Steam. Send me a message through Steam. I'll message you on Steam. What? Message me through the Through the Valve Store? It's the same thing with Battle.net. Like, for 20 years, right? We've been, you know, we've been adding each other on Battle.net. What's your Battle.net friend ID? Give me your Battle.net tag. Send me a message on Battle.net. Oh, is Battle.net down? I mean, even Blizzard's websites. You type in Diablo3.com, you got redirected to us.battle.net/D3. Or, you know, whatever region you're in. Those of us who've been using this for the longest time, we're gonna keep calling it Battle.net. I don't care if you call it the Blizzard Launcher. Yeah, maybe that's gonna work for new fans, but we're gonna keep calling it Battle.net because we've been doing so for 20 years. And that's just gonna cause more confusion with new people. Hey, so what's your Battle.net tag? What? Your Blizzard friend ID. Now, you might counter this by saying, well, Microsoft renamed Internet Explorer to Microsoft Edge. Yeah, because Internet Explorer, it had the worst reputation of possibly any piece of software in the history of computers. Microsoft was smart to do that because they stepped away from that horrible reputation. They're trying to sweep that under the rug. Like, it makes sense if the brand recognition is bad, if hearing the name of the brand makes you want to vomit, yeah, you kind of want to rename. You know, there's a TV show called Bar Rescue, where an American Gordon Ramsay comes and saves a bar, and he always ends up renaming the bar, and that's good, because if the bar is failing and has a bad reputation, then renaming it gives it a fresh start and loses that past bad history. But the history of Battle.net is good. There's no negative connotation anywhere there. So you're throwing away 20 years of neutral to positive connotation to, I guess, build up your own brand, the Blizzard brand. That's fine, I get it. And maybe they're thinking long term. Maybe they're thinking, okay, it's been Battle.net for 20 years, but we want to be a company for another 40 years. We want to be a company forever. So, okay, I guess I could get that. And, you know, maybe this is just me, and I know a lot of you guys feel the same way. Or maybe are even more upset about this than I am. Maybe we're just being old grognards. We'll get over it. We'll get over it. But it'll be an adjustment period. And, you know, what can you do? Is it the end of the world? No. It just seems bizarre for this to happen. We'll be a little upset, but in a year from now, we'll all happily be connecting to the Blizzard portal and... you know, maybe we could even just still call it BNet. A lot of us would say BNet for short anyway. If it's just BlizzardNet, that would be the best transition. So that's that, folks. Blizzard's doing this. It's happening. I'm not super happy about it, but whatever. You know, I'm not gonna send an official complaint to Blizzard or anything. What do you guys think? Are you more upset about this than me? Are you less upset about it than me? Leave your thoughts, folks. Thanks for watching. Special thanks to my Twitch supporters and Patreon supporters for making these videos possible. Quick reminder that we have a few days left to get your name on the Rikers Raiders t-shirt. Check out these other videos and subscribe to join Rikers Raiders to stay up to date on Blizzard news. At BlizzCon 2016, Blizzard will reveal Diablo 4. Now, at the heart of this conspiracy is this simple four-sided die. Let's get real up close on that and bring it into focus here. This little innocuous trinket